I want you guys to do me a favor really quick. Hold your finger over that like button or hold your mouse cursor, whatever it is. Now, if you owned a PlayStation 2 at any given point in your life, drop a like on this video. And in the comment section, let me know, what was your favorite PS2 game of all time? And I'm going to attempt a very hard list because the PlayStation 2 game library is massive, but I'm going to try to rank it down to the top 10 best PlayStation 2 games of all time. Do me a quick favor, everybody. If you enjoy the content, make sure you drop a like, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, and turn on those post notifications. Ring that little bell so you get a notification whenever a new Chaos video goes live, so you can get the ever so important first comment. Kicking off this impossible list is Ratchet & Clank Up Your Arsenal. The PS2 is the best-selling console of all time with over 155 million units as of the recording of this video. But no console gets that big without some really great games to go along with it. And kicking off our list is one of those. Ratchet & Clank used to be one of the main faces of Sony, and Up Your Arsenal is often cited as the best game in the entire series. The game was a 3D action platformer developed by Insomniac Games and published by Sony in 2004, and it was immediately beloved by critics and gamers for everything. Its great level design, its extensive list of weapons and gadgets for you to use, the writing, the multiplayer. It's a shame that Ratchet & Clank have kind of fallen off of Sony's main lineup radar over the last few years, and personally, I would love to see Up Your Arsenal be remastered for modern consoles. At number 9, Okami. Released in 2006 for the PlayStation 2, and then it was later ported over to other platforms, Okami is all I can say is it's a gorgeous game when you played as the Shinto sun goddess in the form of a white wolf. The gameplay was heavily inspired by The Legend of Zelda, but with some key twists, and that's probably why I liked it so much. I like the inclusion of a magic brush that you can use to draw things on the screen to assist you in battle. Okami was critically acclaimed for its structure and its gameplay, and it's often used as one of the main examples of video games as a form of art, thanks to its beautiful cel-shaded visual style and its excellent soundtrack. Resident Evil 4, cited by some people to be the best Resident Evil ever, it was released in 2005 for the GameCube and the PS2, and it's one of the most influential video games of all time for many reasons. One of those is its technical aspects, as well as its alterations to the Resident Evil formula that helped change the way we all play third-person shooters. I mean, it changed it forever. Development started back in 99, but it had to be restarted halfway through due to the project straying way too far from what it was supposed to be. Capcom was looking for a way to recreate the Resident Evil formula as the series had been struggling due to the games feeling repetitive to players. This led to the devs deciding to abandon the fixed camera style of the old games and instead create a brand new camera system that followed the player around as they traversed the map. RE4? Right, it was critically acclaimed. I mean, it was for everything. Its visuals, its camera angle, its gameplay story, and the terrifying monster design. And today, we're pretty used to seeing that over-the-shoulder camera angle that RE4 was the innovator of. Devil May Cry. Remember how I said RE4's development had to be restarted because the project was getting too far off the scope of what it was supposed to be? Well, at that point, Capcom decided not to scrap the existing work, and instead they assigned one of their B teams to keep working on the scrapped RE4, while their main team worked on rebuilding the actual RE4. This resulted in the B team using the scrapped RE4 assets to create this fast-paced, over-the-top hack-and-slash game that we all know and love as Devil May Cry. DMC launched in 2001 for the PS2, and it was one of the most influential action games of all time, thanks to the fast pace, the stylish and over-the-top combat, the cheesy dialogue and story, and the pretty impressive level and monster design. Absolutely, one of the best PS2 games ever released, and it was done by what people considered a B-squad. Speaking of hack and slashers, at number 6, God of War 2. Of course, the original God of War was released in 2005, and it helped bring the hack and slash genre a little bit more into the mainstream gaming world. But God of War 2, well, it launched in 2007, and it expanded upon just about every aspect of the original. That's what you want from the second game in a series. It featured improved combat, longer combo strings, more weapons, better visuals, more interesting puzzles, and platforming for you to do in between combat sections, and a whopping 4 times as many boss fights as the first game had. God of War 2 was one of the best reviewed games on the PlayStation 2, and it's one of the best examples I can think of a game sequel done right. So many sequels now just do more of what the first game did, while God of War 2, a good sequel, will take the formula of the first game and expand upon it in every way possible. Cracking into the top 5, GTA 3. This legendary game, and I don't say legendary lightly, was released in 2001 for the PlayStation 2 before being ported to other systems the following year, and it made a massive impact on the gaming world in multiple ways. Up until this point, Grand Theft Auto had been somewhat of a cheesy top-down action game, but with GTA 3, Rockstar decided to bring the series into the world of third-person action games, complete with a massive open world filled with NPCs, cars, and items for you to interact with, and a very lengthy story that was extremely well written. Grand Theft Auto 3 was one of the biggest technical achievements in gaming history at that time, thanks to the massive map and the open-ended gameplay, and it managed to sell over 14 million copies. Most everybody has played GTA 3 at some point in their gaming career. Shadow of the Colossus. Released in 2005, Shadow of the Colossus is an action-adventure game in every sense of that phrase. You played as a young boy who is given the task of roaming around the world and looking for 16 massive monsters known as Colossi in order to save the life of a young girl. Now, the structure of this game is interesting. It's unusual, as the Colossi are the only enemies in the game, essentially making it a boss rush game, and there are no dungeons or secret levels or anything like that. You just start the game and you hunt. The story and the gameplay were praised, and the visuals are still pretty impressive to this day, thanks to the environment and the monster design. Shadow of the Colossus easily gets a spot on my list today. Let's go back to the GTA well one more time. GTA Vice City. Just 12 months after the release of GTA 3, Rockstar decided to do another take with their new open world formula with the form of Vice City. Some considered this to be the best one ever. It launched in October of 2002 for the PlayStation 2, and then a few months later for PC and Xbox, and it featured a brand new open world set in a fictional version of Miami, Florida in the 80s. Vice City was heavily influenced by Scarface and Miami Vice, and it had an awesome visual style to it. Today, it's one of the best reviewed games of all time, and it managed to sell over 17 million copies. Although, it did spark quite a bit of controversy due to the violence and the drug content, since much of the game was based on the American crack epidemic of the 80s. Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater. Widely considered to be the best in the series, you let me know if it is or if it's not. MGS3 was released for the PS2 in late 2004. It was actually a prequel to the other games. MGS numbering has always been a bit all over the place. The game took place in 1964, and it had you playing as Snake as an undercover mission in the Soviet Union. The storytelling was great. The gameplay was tight, and the setting change from near future back to the 60s made for some pretty interesting encounters and environments. Today, MGS 3 Snake Eater is considered to be the best game in the series, and while it's only sold about half of what MGS 2 did, that's still a whopping 3.6 million copies, and over the years, it's actually gained a ton of extra appreciation from gamers for its storytelling. Okay, and at number one, I lied. We were going to do one more. We're going to do one more GTA game, San Andreas. I mean, we have to. It was the final Grand Theft Auto game of the sixth console generation, and it was released just 2 short years after Vice City. Remember when Rockstar used to put games out almost every year? Not anymore. San Andreas brought the open-world adventure game into the 90s, and it puts you in San Andreas, which was a fictionalized version of California and Nevada. You played as CJ, an ex-criminal who comes home to Los Santos to get his old gang back together in an effort to fight back against corruption. The story was heavily inspired by the real-world gangs of Los Angeles in the 90s, as well as the 1992 LA riots, and the storytelling and the satire of San Andreas was nothing short of excellent, far above anything Rockstar had done so far, and the gameplay was better than ever. Today, San Andreas is considered by many to be the best GTA game of all time, and as of 2011, it's sold over 27.5 million copies, and it's the single best-selling game on the PlayStation 2. And there you have it. That's a hard list. My picks for the 10 best games on the PS2. Obviously, we're going to miss some. Tell me what we missed. I feel like there's thousands of PlayStation 2 games. It's currently the best-selling console of all time, and it didn't get there without some killer games. Exclusive titles have kind of lost their luster now due to how hit or miss they are, but hopefully things can turn around with the next console generation. So, like I said, let me know what your favorite PS2 game is, and I'll see you guys next time.